बिहारी जय राधा
इसको
माधवा,
लाइव करना यार।
बिहारी जय गोपी जना वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपी जना वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोधनंदन ब्रज जनरंजन, यशोधनंदन ब्रज जनरंजन, यमुना तीरा वनचारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज विहारी, जय राधा माधवा कुंज विहारी, कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम राम हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे,
करना चालू करो बच्चे।
हरे रामा राम राम हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम राम हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, जय राधा गोविंद राधा गोविंद राधे राधे, जय जगन्नाथ जगन्नाथ बलदेवा, जय सुभद्रा जय लक्ष्मी नरसिम्हा लक्ष्मी नरसिम्हा, जय जय लक्ष्मी नरसिम्हा, जय गौरानिताय गौरानिताय गौरानिताय, जय गौरानिताय नित्य गौर, हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल, जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 की जय। सो इन योर बुक यू हैव अ स्मॉल मंगलाचरण, विल चैंट द स्मॉल मंगलाचरण एवरी टाइम बिकॉज यू आर वेरी न्यू टू दिस होल सिस्टम, so instead of the big mangalacharan, bigla mangalacharan was explained by you know Chandrapati Prabhu, but we'll have a system of chanting small mangalacharan together, 1 2 3 start. Om agyana thimirandhasya gyananjana shalakya chakshurum
malitam yena tasmai shri guru
namaha, shri chaitanya
manovishtam
tapitam yena bhutale स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं, वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगण ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत श्रीराधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी श्रीराधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय सो द 27 वर्सेस हैज बीन गिवन हरि बोल 27 वर्सेस यू ऑल हैव गॉट 27 वर्सेस इंपॉर्टेंट वर्सेस
I'll share it on the screen, Mataji.
So we'll try to chant 27 verses. Please share it on the screen. Every one of us will try to chant these verses. That will be our every week. This schedule will be there. 27 verses, not this. 27 verses. If it is unable to do, if you are unable to do, then we can do it next time. 27 verses you are able to do, Hari Bol. These are all the standard prayers, not these, not this. 27 verses you are able to do, Hari Bol. 27 important shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. Yeah, we have got it. We have got. So chant along with me. You can read this. All of you are able to see this in the screen. Okay. धृतराष्ट्रुवाच धर्मक्षेत्रे कुरुक्षेत्रे समवेता युयुत्सवः मामका पाण्डवाश्चैव किम कुर्वत संजय यू आर एबल टू हियर ओके देन आफ्टर मी यू चैंट धृतराष्ट्रुवाच
धृतराष्ट्रुवाच
धर्मक्षेत्रे कुरुक्षेत्रे
धर्मक्षेत्रे
पाण्डवाश्चैव
किमकुर्वत संजय
अर्पण्य दोषोपहत स्वभावः
शिष्यस्तेऽहं
शादि मां त्वां प्रपन्नम् अशोचानन्वशोचस्त्वम् प्रज्ञावादांश्च भाषसे
गतासूनगतांसुंश्च
नानुशोचन्ति पण्डिताः देहिनोऽस्मिन् यथा देहे कौमारं यौवनं
जरा
तथा
देहान्तरप्राप्ति
धीरस्तत्र न मुह्यति
धीरस्तत्र
मात्रा स्पर्शास्तु कौन्तेय शीतोष्ण सुख दुख दाह आगमापायिनो नित्यः तांस्तितिक्षस्व भारत For today, 5 out of 27 important shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. We have studied 5. So practice this at home. First 5 shlokas. So once you practice it, then it is easy to pronounce. So then we chant time together. Once we are done with the 27 shlokas, we will try to do 108 shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. Important 108 shlokas of Bhagavad Gita, which are highly quoted verses. So now, last time I had given homework. All of you have done the homework? Very good, wonderful children. I was not so good child. I was the most curious child. I used to never hear to teacher. And you all are so wonderful, very nice children. Some 12th verse on, we saw the diplomacy of Duryodhana. His mind, his action, his word, completely different from each other. Sometimes he is praising his teacher, sometimes he is criticizing, sometimes he has faith in Bhishma's strength, and sometimes he's telling the other soldiers to protect Bhishma. Even Bhishma is confused. What is this? Why this grandson Duryodhana is so much in fear? Maybe he has a doubt that I'm not going to support him. So just to show Duryodhana, or just to keep him happy, Bhishma Pitamaha blew the conch shell. This blowing of the conch shell without speaking indicates that he is ready, or he is accepting to be on the side of Duryodhana, and is accepting even to die on the side of Duryodhana. Let us see from 12th verse. Tasya sanjanayan harsham Guru Vriddha Pitamaha Sihanadam Vinadyo Chai Shankham Dadmau Pratapavan. From 12th verse to 20th verse. This is one section. Today we'll do this section. 12 to 20. This indicates victory on the side of Pandavas. These are the signs of victory. First sign already we have done. That is, first chapter, first verse itself, Dharma Kshetre, Kurukshetre. This small phrase, Dharma Kshetre, Kurukshetre, indicates in this Kurukshetra, Dharma is going to be established. Who told? A person who is completely adharmi. Saraswati somehow made him speak this. Though he did not want to tell this, but it indicates in this Kshetra, Dharma is going to be established. And what is Dharma? Where these four religious principles, that is austerity, purity, truthfulness, compassion, is established. Wherever Krishna is there, Dharma is there. So Dharmastu Sakshat Bhagavat Pranitam. Wherever Krishna is there, Dharma is there. And this place is Dharma Kshetra. That means in this place, Dharma is going to be established. And naturally, Krishna is present on the side of Pandavas, so the victory will be there on the side of Pandavas. So first sign of victory of war is the first verse itself. Second sign of victory of war is this 12th verse. In this 12th verse, here Pitamaha, that is Bhishma Pitamaha, has blown the conch shell. Why? Because he has understood the inner heart of his grandson Duryodhana. And just because of natural compassion as a grandfather has for the grandson, he tried to cheer him up by blowing the conch very loudly. Actually, indirectly, what is the meaning of blowing of the conch? He informed his grandson that there is no chance of victory of war, because wherever conch is blown, conch is subservient to Krishna. Now, blowing of the conch shell of Bhishma Pitamaha indicates that this war is going to be won by Pandavas, onto whose side Krishna is there. That is why even in the houses, the conch shell is blown. conscious means growing of the conscious means adharma is removed, dharma has to be established. So growing of the conscious of by Bhishma Pitama indicates that adharma will be removed in this kshetra, dharma will be established. That is why if you see the in the temples, the pujari, they blow the conch. By blowing the conch, it means all the dharma should be removed from here. Wherever conch is blown, dharma is established. Now in this kshetra, the by blowing the conch, here Bhishma Pitamaha is indirectly telling to Duryodhana that you have no chance to win the war because you are on the side of adharma. Blowing of the conch indicates establishing dharma. So this is the second sign of victory of war. Now let us see what happens after the conch is blown. If you have seen some old movies, Prithviraj Kapoor's movies, you have seen or not? Old movies. When the conch will be blown at that time, immediately some war starts. Immediately the conch is blown. And then some other sounds and all come. Trumpet sounds, kettle drum sounds, pee 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 pee, some different sounds come. That indicates everything is blowing simultaneously. Tumultuous sound is created. Before the war starts, tumultuous sound is created. Here just indicated, here also a war is going to start. The conch is blown. Now then afterwards what happens? Tatha shankasha bhairyascha panavanaka gomukaha sahasaivabhyahanyanta sa shabdastu mulo bhavat. Immediately all the drums, all everything, bugles, trumpets, horns, everything started blowing. And the sound was so tumultuous. Then, when this sound was there, what happened? It was the combined sound was tumultuous and was suddenly sounded. And 14th verse. Tatha shveter hayer yukte mahati sandane sthitau madavah pandavas chaiva divyau shankhau pradatmatuhu. Now here we have another two signs of victory of war in this 14th verse. Tatha shveter hayer yukte. Shveter means white, hayer means horses. Mahati sendane stito. Sendane refers to chariot. The chariot where Lord Krishna and Arjuna are seated, the chariot is mentioned here. That is yoked by the, or it is drawn by the white horses. Tata shveter hayer yukte. Mahati sendane stito. It is not an ordinary chariot. It's a great chariot. This chariot itself is a sign of victory of war. How? This chariot is not an ordinary chariot. It is given by Agni Devata to Arjuna. Many of the Devi Devatas, they gifted Arjuna with some vyudhas. Why? Because they want Arjuna to win the war. So now this chariot has been given by Agni Devata. Agni goes in how many directions? There are how many, total how many directions are there? Total how many directions are there? Somebody can unmute and reply. How many directions are there? Yeah, Manish Jani can reply. Total how many?
Eight directions.
Four directions.
Eight directions, Pakka? Only eight directions are there? Only eight are there?
Yes.
Total there are 10 directions. We have forgotten top and bottom. So total there are 10 directions. So Agni goes in all the directions. So naturally the chariot of Agni also goes in all directions. The other person is unable to understand where is this chariot actually. Is it to the left, to the right, to the top or the bottom or to somewhere to northeast, northwest, where it is. So this chariot itself is a sign of victory of war. And then is given by Agni Devata. And the fourth sign of victory of war. Madhavah Pandavas Chaiva Divyau Shankhau Pratatmatuhu. Who is sitting here? Madhava. Jayastu Pandu Putranam Yesham Pakshe Janardhana. माधव पांडव माधव माधव ये रेफर्स टू हस्बैंड ऑफ गॉडेस ऑफ फॉर्चून माधव सो हस्बैंड ऑफ गॉडेस ऑफ फॉर्चून माधव इज सिटिंग दैट मींस फॉर्चून इज देयर वेयर एवर कृष्णा इज देयर फॉर्चून इज देयर Fortune is there on the side of Pandavas because Krishna is present, and Krishna is present. The goddess of fortune is also there because goddess of fortune never leaves alone without her husband. So victory and fortune are awaiting Arjuna. So in this way, Madhavaha and Pandavaha, Pandu, Jayastu Pandu Putrana. Victory is there for Pandavas. जयस्तु पांडुपुत्राणां वै येषां पक्षे जनार्दन हू हैज टेकन देयर साइड जनार्दन हैज टेकन देयर साइड सो माधवः पांडवः रेफर्स टू लॉर्ड इज प्रेजेंट ऑन देयर साइड सो गॉडेस ऑफ फॉर्च्यून इज प्रेजेंट गॉडेस ऑफ फॉर्च्यून इज प्रेजेंट मींस विक्ट्री इज श्योर इन दिस वे टू मोर साइंस आर देयर इन दिस श्लोक 15th वर्स पांचजन्यं ऋषिकेशो देवदत्तं धनंजय पौंड्रं दद्मौ महाशंकं भीमकर्मा वृकोदरः पांचजन्यं ऋषिकेशो देवदत्तं धनंजय पौंड्रं दद्मौ महाशंकं भीमकर्मा वृकोदरः नाउ द नेम्स ऑफ द कॉन्शियस आर हैविंग गिवन इन दिस 15th वर्स 16th वर्स 17th वर्स The name of the conscious have been given. Let us see. Rishikesha. Who is Rishikesha? Krishna himself. Krishna's one of the name is Rishikesha. What is the meaning of Rishikesha? Rishikaha Ishaha. One who is the controller of our senses. Rishika means senses. Isha means controller. One who directs our senses. One who is the controller of our senses. So, Krishna is known as Rishikesha. Now, Krishna, by here, Panchajana, first Krishna's conscious name is given. Because Krishna's name is first given because Krishna is going to direct the senses of all the Pandavas. Krishna directs the senses of the Pandavas means sure victory. So, this is also one of the sign of victory of one. Panchajanyam Rishikesha. Rishikesha has been mentioned here. That means Krishna is going to direct the senses of the Pandavas. So Pandavas, every move, every action is actually directed by Krishna. Like if the, how the movie runs, if the director is wonderful, then the movie is wonderful, isn't it? Then all the actors, they know what to act. So it is director who actually directs the actor. So Pandavas are actually actors. Who is going to direct them? It is Krishna himself. Now there is a nice story behind Panchajanyam. Let us see the story behind Panchajanyam. Krishna and Balram, they had gone to Sandipani Muni Ashram for learning the arts. Gurukul, children are sent to the Gurukul. So in 64 days, 64 hours, Krishna and Balram studied. So when you study something, a Guru Dakshina has to be given. Na? Where is Guru Dakshina for me? Anyway, I'm not your Guru. So where is Dakshina? But in those days, Guru Dakshina has to be given. That is compulsory. Without Guru Dakshina, education cannot be attained. So now the time of giving Guru Dakshina has come. Then Sandipani Muni is asking. He says, if you really want to give me Guru Dakshina, bring my son back. Because of some reason, his son died and his son was in hell. And he wanted to, because he knew Krishna and Balram are not ordinary people. They are not just ordinary human beings. It's only Krishna can bring his son back. So then, Krishna and Balram, first thing what they did was, they dived in the ocean. They killed a demon, Panchajanya demon. This demon was a snail demon and took the Panchajanya conch shell. And Krishna with this conch shell, he was standing on the outskirts of the hell and started blowing the conch shell. the whole hellish atmosphere became so divine. People there, the sinful, those who have done a lot of sins in this earthly planet, if the earthly planet is not enough to give the punishment, they are sent to the hell. And in the hell, the jivas, they get the yatana sharira. Yatana sharira means the body which is inflicted with so much of troubles. So they are put in the boiling oil, or they are made to roll on the thorny and sandy hot sand. So all these difficulties are given. But what's to happen there? These Yamadutas, they were inflicting so much of difficulties to these jivas who have done so much of sins. But just by the blowing of the conch shell, the whole atmosphere became completely divine and blissful. And people were made to drink hot iron, molten iron. They were drinking very joyfully, as if they are drinking some mango juice. If they were made to roll on the thorny and hot sand, they were rolling as if it is the bed of rose petals. So the whole thing was completely different. People were enjoying instead of crying. So the Yamadutas went to Yamaraj and told the whole Yamaloka that the whole situation is completely different. Yamaraj, with his divine powers, could understand, oh, Lord has come to my place. Immediately he goes and pays obeisances to Krishna and Balram. At that time, Krishna says, because Yamaraj is asking, how best I can serve you? At that time, Krishna asks for the son of Sandipani Muni. In this way, Sandipani Muni's son is brought back by Krishna. This Panchajanyam has a story behind this. So Panchajanyam Rushikesh. Krishna is present. Krishna is going to direct the senses of everyone. Devadattam Dhananjaya. So Arjuna is also known as Dhananjaya, because he helped his elder brother in fetching wealth when it was required by the king to make expenditure for different sacrifices. Rajasuya Yagya was done by Yudhishthira. At that time, a lot of wealth was required. Dhananjaya, Arjita. When a lot of wealth is collected, then it's known as Dhananjaya. So Arjuna is also known as Dhananjaya. Paundram Dadmo Mahashankam Imakarma Vrupodara. Paundram. Mahashankam. This Paundram is Mahashankam. Because who is holding this? Vrukodara is holding. Bhima's another name is Vrukodara. Vrukodara means voracious eater. And how is his work? His work is Bhima Karma. Bhima Karma means Herculean task. So Bhima had killed many demons like Hidimba. His task was Herculean, very, very powerful task. And he used to eat voraciously. That is why his name is Vrukodara. Bhima's name is Vrukodara. Bhima Karma means Herculean task. Herculean, what do you see? Simple word for Herculean. Great task. He used to do great tasks. He used to kill the demons. He used to do all great tasks. So Bhima Karma. Here Bhima is not name. Understand. Bhima Karma refers to type of work. Vrukodara is actually the name here. Bhima is addressed as Vrukodara. So naturally, he's so strong. If you give a small conch shell, then what will happen? He will crush it. That is why Mahashankham. His shankham is very big, very huge. Paundram is the name of his shankham. Rishikesha's shankha's name is Panchajanyam. Arjuna's shankha's name is Devadattam. And Vrukodara's shankha's name is, conch shell's name is Paundram. Then, Ananta Vijayam Raja Kunti Putro Yudhishthiraha Nakulah Sahadevascha Sugosha Manipushpakau. Ananta Vijayam Raja. Yudhishthira is known as Raja because he had done Rajasuya Yagya. After the battle, he had done Rajasuya Yagya. That is why Yudhishthira is addressed as Raja. He is Kunti Putraha. Kunti Putro Ho Yudhishthira. His conscious name is Ananta Vijayam. Then Sahadeva. Nakulaha Sahadeva. Nakula's conscious name is Sugosha. Sahadeva's conscious name is Manipushpakau. Ashyascha Panishpasaha. शिखंडी च महारथः दृष्टद्युम्नो विराटश्च सात्यकीश्च पराजितः काशीराजः काश्यश्च काश्यः द किंग ऑफ काशी ही इज परम ईशु आशः परमेश्वास परम ईशु आशः दैट मींस इज अ ग्रेट आर्चर शिखंडी च महारथः शिखंडी इज आल्सो देयर देयर ऑल महारथीस Then Drishtadyumna is also there. We saw last time Drishtadyumna, the son of Drupad, Drishtadyumna, where Duryodhana mentions, Tavashishena Dhimataha, you were knowing, oh Duryodhana, you were knowing, oh Dronacharya, you were knowing that Drishtadyumna is born to be the cause of your death, but still you taught everything to Drishtadyumna. Drishtadyumna, the king of Drupad is there. Virataha, Virat, Virat Raja is there. Actually, in this, this all princes, that is, this five Pandavas, they took shelter when they were in exile to this king, Virat Raja. Satyaki is also there. The same Yudhana, the charioteer of Krishna. The charioteer of Krishna's name is Satyaki. He is also there. They're all Aparajitaha. Aparajita means they cannot be vanquished. Drupad is there, king of Pancha. Draupadi, the sons of Draupadi is there. Draupadi is the sons, that is, four sons of Draupadi are there. They are all, Sarvashaha Prithivipate. So in this way, Saubhadra, that is, Subhadra's son is there. Abhimanyu is there. They are all Mahabhav, Maitiham, Shankhan, Dadmau, Pruthak, Pruthak. They all started blowing their respective conch. Bhishma Pitama started, then everybody started blowing the conch. So what happened? It was sounding so much. The whole catastrophe was due to King Dhritarashtra because he encouraged the policy followed by his sons. And when this whole conch shell was blown, then this blowing of the conch shell was so uproarious, it was actually shattering the hearts of the sons of Dhritarashtra. In the 16th to 18th, their purport, Srila Prabhupada writes, Sanjaya informed King Dhritarashtra very tactfully that his unwise policy of deceiving the sons of Pandu and endeavoring to enthrone his own sons of the seat of the kingdom was not very laudable. The signs already clearly indicated that the whole Kuru dynasty would be killed in the great battle, beginning with the grandsire Bhishma down to the grandsons like Abhimanyu and others, including kings from many states of the world. All were present there and all were doomed. The whole catastrophe was due to the king Dhritarashtra because he encouraged the policy followed by his sons. He was on the side of Adharma. So the whole destruction is only the causes. Too much of attachment for the throne, for the position. So here, by the blowing of the conch shell, we can understand that the dharma will be established. The dharma will be completely removed. So many kings will be killed. Who is the cause of all this destruction? It is the wrong attachment. Attachment on the wrong platform. Attachment is natural. Every jiva is attached to Krishna. But if he forgets that his attachment is to Krishna, then his attachment is on the wrong platform. When his attachment is on the wrong platform, then the destruction happens. Then everybody has to suffer. Now what happened when the whole conch shell, everything was blowing? So much of sound was there. 19th verse. This is sixth sign of victory of war. Till now five over, now sixth. सघोषोधार्तराष्ट्रानां हृदयानि विदारयत् नभश्च पृथिवीं चैव तुमुलो भनुनादयन् सघोषोधार्तराष्ट्रानां धृतराष्ट्र सन्स हेडेड बाय दुर्योधन धार्तराष्ट्रानां हृदयानि विदारयत् देयर हार्ट्स वर कंप्लीटली शैटर्ड बिकॉज़ नभश्च पृथिवीं चैव द साउंड वाज सो टुमल्टस It was uproaring the whole prithvi, that is the whole surface of the earth as well as the sky. tumulo bhyanunadayan. So uproaring sound. Now, when the conch shell was blown on the side of Kauravas, such mention is not there on the side of Pandavas, that the hearts of the Pandavas broke, nothing, shattered, nothing, nothing. Such indication is not given. But when the conch shell was blown on the side of Pandavas, this indication is given, that it shattered the hearts of the sons of Dhritarashtra. Why Pandavas' heart were not shattered? Because they have complete confidence in Krishna. One who takes the shelter of Krishna, this is practical application of Bhagavad Gita. Last time somebody asked, what is the practical application of Bhagavad Gita? Whoever takes the shelter of the Supreme Personality of Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is Lord Krishna, has nothing to fear. Fearlessness is the first sign of a person who is surrendered. If you are surrendered, you are fearless. In Corona, everybody is having fear. But whoever is studying Bhagavad Gita, their faces is not expressing any fear. All of you are seeing, I'm able to see you all. You all are appearing fearless. Because whoever takes shelter of Bhagavad Gita, that means whoever is taking shelter of the instructions of Krishna is directly taking shelter of Krishna. And whoever takes shelter of Krishna is fearless. In the utmost fearful condition also, he remains fearless. That is why he has nothing to worry, even in the greatest of the great calamity. It is said when Bhishma and others, they were all blowing the conch shell in the side of Duryodhana, there was no heartbreaking on the side of Pandavas. Such instances are not mentioned. But in this particular verse, what is mentioned? The sons of Dhritarashtra's heart were shattered by the sounds vibrated by the Pandavas. Because Pandavas are fearless, because they have Krishna with them. Then 20th verse. So six signs are over. Now 20th verse. There is a seventh sign of victory of war. Atha vivasthitan drishtva dhatarashtran kapidvajaha प्रवृत्ते शस्त्र संपाते धनुरुद्यम्य पांडवः ऋषिकेशं तदा वाक्यं इदमाहमहीपते अथ व्यवस्थितान् दृष्ट्वा धार्तराष्ट्रान् कपिध्वजः. So now Arjuna, at that time the son of Pandu, seated in the chariot bearing the flag marked with Hanuman, व्यवस्थितान् दृष्ट्वा धार्तराष्ट्रान् कपिध्वजः प्रवृत्ते शस्त्र संपाते. What he did, he took up his bow and prepared to shoot his arrows. धनुर् उद्यम्य पांडवः ऋषिकेशं तदा वाक्यं इदमाहमहीपते. O king, after looking at the sons of Dhritarashtra drawn in military array, Arjuna then spoke to Lord Krishna these words. Atha vyavasthitan drishtva. So looking at the arrangement, or the looking at the sons of Dhritarashtra. Now in the Arjuna is going to speak some following words to Krishna. Now Arjuna is seated on the chariot which has the emblem of Hanuman. It has kapidhvaja. The flag is marked with Hanuman. What Hanuman has to do here? Some question can come. Krishna, Hanuman is always with Rama. How is it that Hanuman is with Krishna? There is a story behind this. Arjuna once goes to Rameshwaram. There he finds a monkey sleeping. He wanted actually to cross. But then it is said a general etiquette is you should not cross a body of anyone. It was the tail, the long tail was there. And Arjuna told the monkey, please remove your tail. Then the monkey told, see, I'm so tired. I'm not going to remove the tail. If you want, you lift and remove it. So Arjuna tried to lift the tail, but he could not. The monkey seemed to be small, but the tail was very heavy. So Arjuna could understand this monkey is not ordinary monkey. Then Arjuna told, Arjuna understood that he is none other than Hanuman. Then he told to Hanuman, why is it that your lord wanted the help of monkeys? He could have just shot the arrows and made a wonderful, wonderful bridge. And the monkey told that if the bridge would have been made by the arrows, then we monkeys would jump on it and we would have broken those bridge. Then Arjuna told, okay, let me see. I will shoot the arrows. I will make the bridge. If you are able to break it, if you break it, then I will commit suicide. If you are not able to break it, then you have to become my servant. So in this way, both of them challenge each other. Now Arjuna made a wonderful bridge of arrows. This monkey jumped on it. Immediately the bridge broke. Now according to the condition, Arjuna should commit suicide. Arjuna was about to commit suicide. God appeared in the form of a Brahmana. Brahmana told, how is it that you both have accepted some conditions, but there should be some referee, na? So I will become the referee. Again you shoot the arrows, let me see. So again the bridge was made by the arrows. Now Hanuman was asked to jump on it. So Hanuman started jumping. Nothing happened. He made himself, he expanded his form, huge form. Again he started jumping, nothing happened. So then Hanuman could realize that this Brahmana is none other than my worshipable Lord Rama. And Arjuna could understand that this Brahmana is none other than my worshipable Lord Krishna. So Rama and Krishna are non-different. At that time, Lord says that, Hanuman, according to the condition, you have to serve Arjuna. So promise me that when there will be a war, you will be present in the chariot. Because wherever Hanuman is there, victory is there. The emblem of Hanuman on the flag of Arjuna is another sign of victory, because Hanuman cooperated with Lord Rama in the battle between Rama and Ravana. So Rama became victorious. So that is why Lord took promise, oh Hanuman, you should be there with Arjuna. Wherever Hanuman is there, victory will be there, because Hanuman is servant of Krishna. Rama, Krishna, don't be confused, Supreme Personality of Godhead, one person only. So in this way, Lord Krishna is Rama himself, and wherever Lord Rama is his eternal servitor, Hanuman will be also there, and his eternal consort, Sita, the goddess of fortune, are present. Therefore, Arjuna had no cause to fear any enemies whatsoever. And above all, the Lord of the senses, Rishikesha, is also there. In this way, who is going to direct all the senses of the Pandavas? Thus, all the good counsel was available to Arjuna in the matter of executing the battle in such auspicious conditions arranged by the Lord for his eternal devotee by the lay the signs of assured victory. So we have seven signs of victory of war in this 12 to 20. First sign was the first verse itself. Small gap will do. And the second sign of victory of war was in the 12th verse. 3 and 4 was there in the 14th verse. 5th sign of victory in the 15th verse. The mentioning of the name of Krishna as Rishikesha. Sometimes Krishna is addressed in different ways, like Madhavaha, Rishikesha. You should note down also. You should note down how many ways Krishna is addressed. When Krishna is addressed as Madhava, then there is a significance of that name. That means goddess of fortune is there. When Krishna is addressed as Rishikesha, immediately you should understand, oh, Krishna is going to direct all the senses. So in this way, when Krishna is addressed in different ways, that signifies that verse. So fifth sign of victory is there. Then sixth sign, how many signs became? Sixth sign. Sixth sign is 19th verse itself, where the sons of the Rashtras were all in a fearful condition. Whoever does not take the shelter of Krishna will be always fearful. Any situation will cause them fear and anxiety. One takes the shelter of Krishna is always fearless. Because when you take the shelter of Krishna, we are in our constitutional position. our constitutional position is we are servant of Krishna. When we serve Krishna, naturally our senses are directed properly. So then we are fearless. When these senses are serving the Maya, it becomes fearful. Maya das, sada udas. Krishna das, sada bindas. Nice proverb is there. Krishna das, bindas. You put mask, you don't put mask. But I have seen people nowadays some craziness is there. If you are alone also, they put the mask and sit. You go to a common place, it's okay. So much of fear is there. Is driving alone in the car and puts the mask. You go to marketplace, some sense is there. If you're alone in the car, you put the mask. That much fear is there. So much of fear. This fear has gone in the brains. Actually, the disease is not corona. The disease is fear, actually. So much of fear has gone in the minds of the people. And what is that fear? Fear of death. It means everybody is afraid of death. Oh, this virus should not attack me. I'll die. That means fear of death is there. But if a person has taken shelter of Krishna, why is he fearless? Because he knows that one day death has to come. The body has to die. But the soul never dies. If it is corona or something else, you cannot skip away your death. The death is only for this form. The matter also does not die. We saw last time, 5 subject matters in Bhagavad Gita, out of which 1 is changeable, 4 is eternal. Soul, God, time, and there is Kala and matter, Prakriti. So matter is indestructible. Form taken by the matter. What I see in the mirror is my form, the form taken by the matter. What dies is a form taken by the matter. Matter does not die. That means when I'm looking at the mirror, I'm only seeing the form taken by the matter. I don't know about the matter also properly. There are 24 elements, which I don't know. I am just thinking about this form. I'm so attracted to this form. And I'm attached to the people related to this form. Aham mama iti agyanam. Last time we saw, aham mama iti agyanam. Dhritarashtra is in agyana. That is why he said, mama kaha pandavaha. My sons, Pandu sons. Aham mama iti agyanam. So much of attachment to the position. Fear of not losing the throne. So that makes Dhritarashtra ask the simple things. Even when he is declaring that my sons and the Pandu sons have assembled for war, he is asking, what are they doing, O Sanjaya? Sanjaya, who is the disciple of Vyasa, who has this Duradrishti. He can see, he can visualize sitting in the palace. Asking, what are they doing? Why such question is there? Because he does not want his sons to compromise in the war. He does not want. He does not want his sons to be influenced by the holy place, by the holy people also. He does not want his sons to become dharmic. That is how the first verse we saw, that how Dhritarashtra is completely in fear. From the second verse we saw till 11th verse, Duryodhana is also in fear. His diplomacy is only because of the fearful state of mind. That is why a person acts in duplicity. You cannot believe such people. What is there in their mind and outside they are something. Inside they have so much of enviousness, so much of hatred. But outside they will show as if they are so wonderful. Enviousness is the part of part of this material world. Like you get something free along with it. So Lord has given this material world along with that something free. And what is that something free? Enviousness. So enviousness is a part of this material world. somebody, what is the meaning of enviousness? If you have to define enviousness, how will you define? Para utkarshanam asahanam. Write down this phrase. Para utkarshanam. Para utkarshanam asahanam. Because we say, oh, this person is envious. What is the meaning of enviousness? Para utkarshanam asahanam. Somebody is happy. Then what is happening? You have a song. Kuch kuch hota hai. Isn't it? I feel like to sing that song, isn't it? But that song is not love. That song is enviousness. Nice tune is there for that song. You want me to sing that song? That just that line? Kuch kuch hota hai. Right? Right? You'll say, hey, what is this? Bhagavad Gita class or film song? But that is reality. Kuch kuch hota hai. Somebody is happy, and especially the person who is near to you, who is very close to you, your classmate. The classmate who is sitting with you, if he gets more marks, then the child kuch kuch hota hai. And if your colleague gets promotion and if you are not getting, then kuch kuch hota hai, isn't it? Two children, same mother. For me too, I and my sister, always there is to be competition. If even 1 inch the dress is somewhere here and there, same color, same type of dress, if something extra is given, then kuch kuch hota hai. So para utkarshanam asahanam, understand, this is the meaning. Somewhere somebody is rich, you are not bothered. If your sister is rich, your brother is rich, then something happens. Now here, Kauravas and the Pandavas, same family. That is why Dhritarashtra was very much envious that my brother's son should not get. Somebody is king somewhere else, he is not bothered. But my brother's son should not get. So that is known as enviousness. Para utkarshanam asahanam. So in this way, we saw the signs of victory of war on the sides of Pandavas. Because Krishna is present, Dharma is there. Wherever Krishna is present, Jayastu Pandu Putrana, Yesham Pakshe Janardana. So wherever Krishna is there, victory is there. That is why chanting of the holy name is very, very important. What is the first qualification to understand Bhagavad Gita? Because we are all the students of Bhagavad Gita. How are we going to study Bhagavad Gita? How are we going to understand Bhagavad Gita? Because Bhagavad Gita are the instructions of Krishna. Without Krishna's name, Krishna's instructions cannot be understood. That is why chanting of the holy name is very, very important. Every day, one should start chanting the holy name. If he is starting for the first time, then at least 2 rounds should be started. If he is practicing chanting, he should at least reach minimum 16 rounds. Minimum 16 rounds. If you are very new, at least start with 2 round chanting. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. By chanting the holy name, we revive our lost relationship. If you want to love somebody, how will you love without calling his name? How will you express that love? Will you say, hey boy, come here. Hey girl, come here. You call by name, isn't it? To whom you love, you call by name. So until unless you express your love to Krishna, how are we going to revive our lost relationship? It is revival of our lost relationship that we are servant of Krishna. That's why chanting of the holy name is very, very important. Without chanting, we can never understand Bhagavad Gita. Even if we try to break our head with all the verses, try to memorize all the verses, Krishna tells in Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter, Tesham satata yuktanam bhajatam priti purvakam dadami buddhi yogam tam yena mam upayanti. I give that knowledge. To whom? Tesham satata yuktanam. Whoever is always connected to me, I give this knowledge to him. That means by our endeavor, we cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. It is by our sincere efforts, by our sincere surrenderance, by our sincere connection, Krishna himself will reveal this knowledge. That is why chanting of the holy name is the first thing what we have to do. That is the foremost requirement for studying Bhagavad Gita. We can write answers, everything wonderful. We can get the certificates also. But understanding the Guhya Jnana, the most confidential knowledge. We saw the chapters' names last time. 9th chapter is Rajavidya, Raja Guhya Yoga. We'll revise that chapter's names also. Small revision. So first chapter is Sainya Darshana Yoga. Sainya Darshana. What happened when Arjuna saw the armies? He started crying. Oh Krishna, I cannot fight. He started giving the reasons. How can I fight with my own people? My own family members? The whole family will be destroyed. I will be the cause of this sin. In this way he cries. Arjuna Vishada Yoga. It's also known as Arjuna Vishada Yoga. Arjuna is crying. Imagine his grandfather, all the whole family members are there on the other side. So he's crying. Then in the second chapter, we'll find Krishna giving the knowledge. Sankhya Yoga. Why in the first chapter, Krishna did not give the knowledge? Knowledge is only given to those people who are surrendered. In the second chapter, we find that Arjuna surrendered. Shishyasteham shadi mam tvam prapannam. Oh Lord, I have surrendered unto you. When Arjuna surrenders, Krishna gives knowledge. Till that time, the talk between Krishna and Arjuna is on the friendly level. But the real knowledge is given. That is Sankhya. Sankhya means analysis. Everything. The Sankhya Yoga. Complete analysis is given by Krishna. Complete knowledge is given by Krishna only when Arjuna surrendered. Now in the second chapter, in one place Krishna says, one has to do the karma. Actually, it is not karma, it is karma yoga, Krishna has told, but Arjuna did not understand. In another place, Krishna says, keep all the abominable activities at a far distance. So that confused Arjuna. What to do? Whether should I fight? Karmanyavadikaraste? Or durena yavaram karma? What should I do? Whether should I fight? Whether should I give up the fight? That is how in third chapter, he expresses his confusion. Oh Lord, I'm completely confused. What to do? Whether should I fight? Whether should I give up the fight? Then Krishna teaches what is karma yoga. In the third chapter, there's a most important verse is there. Third chapter, 9th verse. Yajyathat karmano netra loko yam karma bandhanah tadartham karma kaunteya mukta sanga samachit. If the activity is done for Krishna, then that activity will liberate us. If the same activity is done for our own sense gratification, then that activity becomes a cause of our bondage. Activity is not a problem. Whether to perform an activity or give up an activity, that was the question. So Arjuna, Krishna says, activity is not a problem. What is the consciousness behind the activity? Are you cooking for your family or Krishna? Then you say, if I go, then what I'll do with my children? I have to feed them. You cook for Krishna, give them Krishna prasadam. Then nobody is bound. Everybody will be liberated. If you cook for your sense gratification, then if you eat food without offering to Krishna, then a person is known as Stena. Stena means thief. Krishna says he is a thief. Ishtan bhoga ni bo deva dasente yagya bhavitaha. Stena means he is a thief. That is how if the work is done for Krishna, that becomes the cause of our liberation. So all those things are spoken in the third chapter. In the fourth chapter again, the same karma, jnana karma yoga, perform the activity with complete knowledge. What is that knowledge? Janma karma cha me divyam evam yovitti tattvataha tektva deham punarjanma naiti mameti sorjuna. Krishna is completely transcendental. Janma karma cha me divyam. Krishna is transcendental. Krishna's birth is transcendental. Krishna's activities are transcendental. Any activity keeping Krishna in the center is also transcendental. That is why it is above the three modes of material nature. That is why Jnana Karma Yoga, not just Karma Yoga, perform the activity with complete knowledge. What is that knowledge? Any activity done for Krishna, keeping Krishna in the center. Like you're taking care of your children, you're maintaining your house, that house is not your house. You're only a servant of that house, which is actually, who is the proprietor of that house? Krishna is the proprietor of everything. Isha Vasem Idam Sarva. So that house is only the facility which has been given so that you can chant the holy name of Krishna nicely. You can serve Krishna nicely. So the facility is what has been given to us, because we cannot just sit on the roads and chant the holy name. We are not so elevated. We have to have some roof. And for maintaining that roof, we go to the office. But what is the thing? Worship is the real work. Not work. Work is worship. Worship is the work. To perform that worship, we are having certain facilities. So, Jnana Karma Yoga. Understanding that every activity done with for Krishna, keeping Krishna in the center, that work becomes completely transcendental. Jnana Karma Yoga. Then, fifth chapter, Karma Sannyasa Yoga. Perform the activity. Sannyasa. What is the meaning of sannyasa? Understand that all the, who is the enjoyer of all the, all our fruits. Because activity means you will get fruits, fruits of that activity. It is Krishna. Bhokta Ram Yajnatapasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Surudam Sarvabhutanam Yatva Mam Shanti Mruchati. In this way, the person can attain peace. Everybody are into peace formula. But real peace is in understanding Bhokta Ram. Who is the one who is the enjoyer? It is Krishna who is the enjoyer of all our karmas, all our, even the jnanis, they perform so much of austerity. So one should understand the enjoyer is Krishna. If he understands this, then that is karma. He is not having the asakti or attachment to the fruits of the activity. That is known as Karma Sannyasa Yoga. Then Dhyana Yoga. Arjuna asked, please describe how to control the mind and senses. In this way, Krishna described the Ashtanga Yoga. But then Arjuna says, it's so difficult to control the mind. Chanchala, mind is so much chanchala. Then Krishna says, Yoginam api sarvesham. Yoginam api sarvesham. Who is the topmost of all the yogis? One who is always connected with me. That person is the topmost of all the yogis. Yoginam api sarvesham. So in this way, Krishna says, it is difficult to control the mind. That is right. But whoever is connected to me, madgadena antaratmana shaddhavan, how? With complete faith. So what is the qualification for studying Bhagavad Gita? Faith. Faith is the qualification. Complete surrenderance to Krishna and faith. That is what is given here. Shaddhavan bhajate yomam. Same yuktatamo mataha. Yoginam api sarvesham. There are so many yogis, but topmost of all the yogis, madgadena antaratmana shaddhavan, with complete. So in this way, in the sixth chapter, you will find the topmost of dhyana is understanding our relationship with Krishna and acting in that capacity. So first six verses, a summary of first six verses I have given. First six verses, we saw that how whole Bhagavad Gita is divided into three parts. The first six is known as Karma Yoga. Middle six is known as Bhakti Yoga. And the last six, 13th to 18th, is known as Jnana Yoga. So first six we saw in the first chapter, it was crying. Second chapter, knowledge has been given. Third chapter, what type of work has to be done, which will liberate us. In the fourth chapter, we saw that work should be done with complete knowledge of Krishna. Fifth chapter, we saw that how the reactions of all the karmas can be removed if a person understands the real enjoyer is Krishna. And sixth chapter we saw that how the topmost of all the dhyana meditation is understanding of a relationship with Krishna and acting with that capacity. So all that actions should be done with that capacity. That is why chanting of the holy name revives us, our lost relationship, connects us with Krishna. So here we'll stop. We can take some questions.